morning, FHS. I'm Emily.
And I'm Lindsay with your Wednesday news. Congratulations to Landon Blix and Ava Yan won a special prize at the Scholarship Alert Show at Lansing Art Gallery. Each of them won $100 in the art supplies from O'Leary's Paint and MSU Art Store. Great job.
Students, please check the job board outside the counseling office for more information on opportunities to work for Patrick Carbide Tool and Die and the Livingston County Road Commission.
Underclassmen, if you didn't hear, the school year has been extended to June 10th. We must have at least 60% of the student body attend that day to count as a day.
This week we had a chance to catch up with the counselors.
All right, guys, today we're going to be keeping up with the counselors. Let's see what they have to say.
Hi, we're back with keeping up with the counselors. This week we're doing M-Step makeup, so if you missed any M-Step testing, Thursday, April 18th, during fifth hour, you are to report to the Media Center Lab B for M-Step.
Okay, and then just a reminder, you know, we're coming up on the end of the school year. We only have 2 months left and less than that, actually. And if you're a senior, even less than that. So get your grades up to where you want them so that we can avoid having to talk to you about summer school in the next month or so. So finish strong. Keep your grades up, do your homework, study hard, and finish strong.
Thanks for watching, and make sure you keep your grades up and you finish strong.
With the NHL playoffs starting this week, we went out to get FHS's playoff predictions.
I'm Christian Montrose. We're going to go around FHS and see all the hockey fans out there and get their predictions on the Stanley Cup playoffs. We're here with Sawyer Walker, not a big hockey guy, but, you know, we're going to get his playoff predictions for the Stanley Cup finals or playoffs.
You know, I got to go with my boys. I had them last year, stuck with them again this year. Got to go with my Caps, you know. Ovi's going to get it done again. Great guy. Loves the game. Yeah, he's going to do good.
All right. You heard it. We're here with Josh Leonard, Jr., big hockey guy, so we're going to get his playoff predictions.
You know, I'm going to go with the Lightning, go Bolts. I don't know anything about hockey, but that's what we're going with.
All right. We're here with Kyle Lutz, hockey guy. What are your predictions for the Stanley Cup playoffs?
Tampa's winning it all.
Tampa.
No cap.
Bold prediction. Do you think they make it out of the first round?
Oh, yeah.
Okay, you heard it here first.
Or Toronto.
He's changing his mind now. Tampa may not be the pick.
Tampa or Toronto, one of the two.
All right. I'm here with Tyler Sladek, senior. What are your hockey playoff predictions?
Well, I think the Bruins are going to win because they got Chara, and that man's pretty unstoppable.
He's a pretty big guy. Oh, look at this. We got another guy coming on.
Hi.
Sam Hockey Guy Brown.
Hello.
What are your playoff predictions?
Yeah, I got Sidney Crosby going all the way.
Big Penguins fan. You hate to see it, but he's got the Penguins winning it all.
Now back to our Fowlerville sports. The varsity softball team dominated Lansing Eastern Tuesday night, defeating them 16-0 and 20-0. Leah Ash pitched a perfect game in game one and struck out nine of the batters. Carly Atkinson was the winning pitcher in the second game, allowing just two hits and striking out four Lansing Eastern batters. The team put together 25 hits of the night and were led by the sophomores Aaron Zeminski, Parker Douglas, and Morgan Byerly, who all hit a home run in the first game. The Glads are now 4-6, 2-0 in league, and will take on league rivals Williamson next Tuesday. The JV softball team was able to shut down Lansing Eastern in three innings for both games last night. Mara Menard pitched a no-hitter in the first game. Ashley Daly and Haley Dargy were able to do the same for the second game. It was Ashley Daly's first appearance of the season as a pitcher. The girls are home next Tuesday. Great job, ladies.
The JV baseball team improved to 3-1 with a sweep of Lansing Eastern. Game one featured a combined no-hitter thrown by James Anderson and Derek Simonson. Trevor Peterson and Isaac Way recorded multiple hits in game one. Peterson led the change with three hits. Defensively, the Gladiators did not commit an error. Game two saw another offensive explosion from Fowlerville, scoring 14 runs in the third inning. James Anderson, Tyler Biggis, Zach Kurd, Morgan Much, Micah Kivular, and Trevor Patterson all drove runs in the first in for the Glads in the big inning. Kurd picked up the win on the mound while Ryan Dixon and Tyler Quinn came on the relief to secure the victory.
Varsity baseball stays hot with a sweep of East Lansing. Winning 12-0 and 17-4, Caden Flannery and Joey Quigley turned a quality pitching performance, while Brendan Young homered twice on the day. The boys are now 9-0 in the season and play Saturday at Bay City West. Great job, boys.
The varsity tennis team beat Owosso 7-1 on Monday night. Winning in singles was Emma Arnott, Bree Earls, and Emily Radenbaugh. The Glads swept the doubles winning teams were Maddie Allen, Olivia Olmstead, Shelby Durbin, and Joy Lockhart, Courtney Moulton, Kenner Filburn, and Kayleen Lemieux, and Gabby Jupri. Grace Shea lost a hard-fought match at three singles, 1-6, 6-4, 10-7. We are 2-1 in open league and play Thursday versus St. John's. That's all we have for you today. I'm Emily.
And I'm Lindsay, signing off.